God has brought me to life, and I want to keep it there, amen? So we're going to sound like the church, we're going to look like the church, and we're going to feel like the church. Are you guys ready? Come on. This is what it sounds like. Come on, church. This is what it looks like. Hey, hey. This is what it feels like when the church is alive. One more time.
Jesus, the same. I believe in you. I know that many of us have written down some things on those I believe cards. I want us to take a moment and apply our faith this morning. I know that we would love to pray with you, which we're going to pray corporately, but I want you to stir the heart within you And I want you to believe, God, for a minute. I just want you to believe that whatever impossible situation you're going through right now, I want you to be like that blind Bartimaeus when everyone else was saying to be quiet. He prayed all the more. He shouted all the more, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. And so let's just have this attitude of not only blind Bartimaeus, but how about also like the woman with the issue of blood? When she was excommunicated from a community, when there was no more healing for her, when there was no more finances for her, she went against all the odds and she said, if only I touch the hem of his garment, I will be made whole. And so what if this morning we were like a blind Bartimaeus or a woman with the issue of blood, and we're saying, no matter what, man, we're going to go in and we're going to believe God and we're going to trust God and we're going to declare that God is who he says he is. And this morning, I can have a turnaround this morning, regardless of what I feel, regardless of what I think, regardless of what I see. I serve a God who does the impossible. How many believe that this morning? You believe that with all your heart. And I just feel like this is the perfect room right now, the perfect atmosphere for a miracle. Because you know what? Right now, there are people here that are believing God for a miracle. And your miracle doesn't necessarily need to look like you need a car or you need a house. No, that's not a miracle. Your miracle could be that, you know what? Right now, I just need peace from God because I'm tormented. Right now, I need God to show up because my family member is in the hospital bed right now. And there is no distance in prayer. There's no distance in faith. We can choose to believe this moment, this hour, where all of a sudden, as we're all praying as a church, that there are things that are happening beyond and behind the scenes that we can't see. Everything starts in the spirit, and then it manifests in the flesh. And so let's just believe whatever it is you're believing for. Maybe there's trouble at work. Maybe there's trouble in your family. And maybe right now it's you just left trouble. But guess what? God wants to trouble every single trouble you have when you put your trust back in him. Another story in the Bible was the man who had no limbs, specifically no arms. And he looked at the man and he said, stretch out your hand. Well, he had no hand. What's there to stretch? But by faith, this man was willing to stretch out something he didn't have. And because he was willing to trust and believe God for that one moment, he got his miracle. His hand grew out. His arm grew out. His fingers came up. And so guess what? As we lift up our voice, as we lift up our hands, as we lift up our worship to God, God can do a miracle. Amen? So let's sing this together first before we pray. And it's called Turn Your Eyes to Jesus. Let's worship together.
Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. And the things grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace.
Let's all sing this together. Turn your eyes. Go ahead. Let's all sing this.
Oh, turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the his glory and grace.
Lift your hands to heaven and just pray this for me. Say, Heavenly Father, I come boldly to your throne of grace. and I kneel at the altar of my heart. I surrender and I turn my eyes back to you. I may not be able to change my situation, my issue, my problem, my circumstance. But as I set my eyes on you, as I put my trust in you, what's impossible with me is possible with you, God. And so this day, I choose to give you my worship. This day, I choose to trust you. This day, I choose to believe you, Jesus. Without you, I can do nothing. And so help me, God. Help me this day as I pray the Lord's Prayer. Now let's look up on the screen. That was your cue, media. Please place the Lord's Prayer up there. Let's start reading at the count of three at our Father. Ready? One, two, three. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Can we give the Lord a big hand clap of praise? Come on, give him a big hand clap of praise and say, thank you, Lord.
Oh,
Jesus, I hope forever. You made a way. You made a way. See the light tearing through the darkness. Hear the roar of the rugged cross. Jesus Christ, you alone have saved us. We worship you now. See
sing at church.
No wonder we sing.
This is why we sing.
Jesus,
Jesus, I hope. Hope.